right. Thanksgiving, about to train legs. This is the perfect day to train legs. But you know, I'm gonna eat like a pig later. Just warming up here on the treadmill. Gonna do some rearranging in here because I got that new piece of equipment over there. So put the treadmill in the corner. Everybody had a good blackout Wednesday. Well, I fucking did. Thank you. Yeah, it was my birthday a couple days ago. 42. Chipmunk. That's in the mind. Well, I look like a chipmunk now. Getting a lot of questions about the Olympia since it's in Orlando this year, but I doubt I'm going to be able to go. It's too close to Christmas. The week before Christmas, it's too hard to get off. Somebody just sent me a meme of that big black guy that's sitting on the side of the bed with his hammer hanging down as a turkey. Jesus Christ. When's the next podcast? Ask Lenny. He always says to ask me. Me and Andrew have always said, if you want to in the evening, anytime during the week. And Lenny fucking, he doesn't work, so he can make time. Where's the ballots? I don't know. If Florida's a red state, he's going to win Florida anyway. It doesn't really matter down here. Yeah, I'm still on TRT. I'll never get off TRT. Once in a while, I'll take like a week or two off. My cooking? No, my mother is. We're going to my mother's a little bit later. Lenny's having Thanksgiving with his mom and brother and sister. Cynthia was good on the podcast. She had her back. We don't do podcasts. I'm like, you know. What am I gonna do? Walk around and shoot. Doctor prescribed cardio? No. I just gotta warm up, man. Slept in nicely. Lenny, you are always available for podcasts, okay. So name a day, buddy. I get the TRT from my doctor. Only costs me $10 a month, 200 megs a week. I haven't seen Jason in a while. Andrew sees him at the gym a couple times a week, actually. He said he's back to his old self. He wish he could film him, but Jason refuses to. I think he actually deleted that Instagram that he had just put up because his family was on to him. So, because one of you idiots had to go fucking troll his uncle. How many steps do I do a day as a postman? I don't know. I don't know how many steps, but whatever 5 miles is. Carterine? I don't know what that is. No. Did I try the new hack squat machine? I'm gonna do it today. But I did test it out to make sure it doesn't fucking fall apart. It's excellent. DM Brad, thanks Lenny, you fucking cocksucker. They do anyway, doesn't mean you even need to tell them. All the stuff's at Andrew's house, we can go. I spoke to Andrew the other day about it, he said anytime, just let me know. We're always on hiatus, you guys know that by now. We're consistently inconsistent. No, I'm not overloaded, this is not, dude, I'm going at 3 miles per hour right now. It's just to get the blood flowing to the legs. I would love to Jason's Thanksgiving dinner video. I don't know. Did he ever do a Thanksgiving video? I don't think so. I am an old man now. So I'm not old. I'm 42. I feel like I'm 25. It's great. fucking huge. Actually, I got up last time I did a live, it was at the LA Fitness. I just dropped the fucking phone. I weighed myself there. I was 208, now I'm back down to 200. Yeah, I stuffed her this morning actually. I was just running outside with the dogs too a little bit, chasing those idiots around. See how big the little one's getting. Have you seen that troll, Bradford Murray? Yeah, whatever. There's so many troll accounts out there, it's fucking ridiculous. Calves are gonna grow. Yeah, I did calf raises on it the other day. It's excellent. It's a little low. You gotta kind of squat down to get into it, but Lenny's gonna have a hard time with that, but it'll work. I know I don't look 25. I said I feel 25. There's a difference. Puppy's good, man. I'm the same age as Tom Brady, who looks older than me, obviously. I got more gray. Thanksgiving. I look like a Chinaman. I'm squinting to look at this shit. I might have to buy readers soon. My fucking vision's getting kind of shitty. No, I said that earlier. I don't think I'm going to go to the Olympia. It's a week before. It's bad timing. Plus, who knows what they're going to do with an expo. I don't know. Nate messaged me about it. Lenny messaged me about it. Happy that the libtards won the election. No, I think there's a lot of fucking fuckery going around. A lot of fucking fuckery, like an idiot. There's definitely some fuckery with all that. Allergic reaction to peanuts. I'm actually not allergic to anything. I just have shitty sinuses. I wake up, have to fucking blow my nose for a half hour once I get up. Lenny's just running TRT too. Is it crust in my hand? I don't know. Probably a piece of dust. How many digits in Taco Queen's pooper? Just a thumb. Lenny, Brad, I'm always able to squat down to get into you. Ooh, coming out more and more, buddy. I guess that wig I wore turned you on that night. That was fun, we had a good time. I had a lot more footage, but yeah, some people don't want to be in videos, so I couldn't post a lot of it, but we had a fucking good time. And Lenny went to Denver the very next morning. Yeah, I'm surprised he fucking made it. He was very nervous about that trip. The one thing I've noticed it's done for him is he's twitching a lot less. But for that amount of money, just to get rid of twitching, I don't know. I'm not really sold on that shit, to be honest with you. It seems like it's something that would... It's like a temporary thing, you know. You just go back to your ways in a few months anyway. It may work for some people. I'm skeptical about it. No, Lenny wasn't pissing in the car. He was pissing on the side of it. Whenever he comes and meets me, first thing he does is take a leak, wherever we're at. I'm not allergic to podcasts, Lenny. I've told you. When I'm working, I'll go over to Andrew's right after work, meet you there any night of the week. Do I take hair supplements? No. Dude, I got good hair, man. I'm lucky. My dad still has a full head of hair, too. And my mom's father had hair until he died when he was 92, so. I'm lucky. Spastic Eagle. What's that? I feel like I'm getting bigger, but I'm not gaining any weight. It's recompening, right? Is that what it's called? Eduardo on podcast. We met him at Mel Chauncey's thing a few years ago. And he was cool, actually. He rolled with it. He knew. He's like, I'm not even Mexican. I said, I don't know. Who gives a fuck? It's hot in here, man. I don't have the fan on. I'll open up the windows and the door to get the breeze flowing. Actually got warmer today. Swollen face, got feasting. You guys know I got a fat head. My steak and cake was good. I know I saw you criticize that she posted pictures of herself. Ooh, I took those pictures actually. I don't care. It's like seeing a chick in a bikini at the fucking beach. What's the difference? You guys get to take shit way too seriously. Cuck still training? I don't know. That shit's never gonna happen. I said, you wanna do that shit? Go to a fucking public park, square off a little area in the grass, put your gloves on, whatever you need, and fight it out. People at the park would think you're just training, because there's dildos that run around the park doing CrossFit and exercise shit anyway. You could get away with having a little sparring match. Nobody would say shit. There's no, you're not gonna be able to sue anybody. It's a public park. That's the easiest way to do it. But, you know, you gotta make shit difficult. What's my current masturbation? Why would you wanna know that, you homo? I don't have to masturbate anymore. Oh God. That's another false accusation about her. It's expected. People love to talk shit. Make shit up with no proof. My cycle is 200 makes a test a week. I say that every time I come on. I haven't changed it up at all. What's my favorite Thanksgiving pie? My mother makes fucking pumpkin cheesecake. That's unbelievable. I eat the whole fucking thing. That's my favorite for sure. Big Richard is good. Actually, it's funny. I spoke to him. His mailman ran into him on election day. Richard was working the... Oh my God, I'm way behind on these. Richard was working the polls in his neighborhood. They had an election. They had, you could go vote there. So he volunteered to work the polls. And his mailman did a video call on WhatsApp to me. And I talked to Richard. He was fucking hilarious. He had a ring on his finger. I said, oh, what's that? He's like, ah, you know, I'm a softy like that. It's a promise ring. I said, what? A promise ring to his new girlfriend. He gets a new girlfriend every 2 years about. He said she loves to fuck. I said good. 70 years old, still slinging dick. It's great. He said, I wish I could have recorded the call, but I don't know how to do that shit. It was funny though, our back and forth, just like old times. He looks good. I think Richard's 70 or 71. Yeah, fucking promise ring, you believe that? Alpha Dog Richard wearing a fucking promise ring. I couldn't believe it. I was breaking his balls. I do half cc on Monday or Tuesday, and a half cc on Thursday or Friday. That's it. So I pin it twice a week. Happy Spanksgiving. You don't need a mask in this gym. You mean your muzzle? I'm so glad I got all this fucking equipment and don't have to go to a commercial gym. It's fucking great. I don't miss that shit whatsoever. Waiting for jerk-offs, five people on one fucking piece of equipment. No fucking thanks. Yeah, I should be wearing a mask to protect the viewers. I don't know, man, quit asking about a podcast. I don't know when. I need a promise. Why don't you, Lenny? You're the one that bitches out. I told you. It's up to you. Not me and Andrew aren't gonna do one, just me and him. It's gotta be at least three of us. Talk agree to you, Rusty. No, she doesn't eat my ass, and I wouldn't want her to. That's fucking gross. Your boys train with you. Now, well, my son, he's back from college for now. He comes over and trains. Fuck forgiveness. I hate that. You gotta forgive. Fuck you. You forgive people. If you want to, that's up to you. Yeah, you can forgive. People have been forgiven more than once. And you can't forgive somebody that you know is just gonna fucking turn around and continue to be a complete blithering idiot. No thanks. Richard girl loves to fuck. Oh, Lenny. You can't say that. You can't say that. And I don't need to say anything about the jellyfish. He can go on and embarrass himself all he wants. Forgives. I don't want to hear that shit. If you want to forgive, that's some people, yeah, they deserve to be forgiven, and some people don't. So, it is what it is. I'm good at eliminating toxic people out of my life. Oh, McCuck. Is that the real McCuck? Anyone thinks that behavior is acceptable and cool, put it, I can't, yeah, I don't agree with telling somebody they should commit suicide. I want the guy to commit suicide or die. I'd rather see him suffer. Misery loves company. That's the bottom line. You know, some people grow up spoiled and getting whatever they want when they throw a little temper tantrum. Never hear the word no. Never get slapped around for acting like a jerk off. And that's what you get. When you get older, it doesn't stop, you know? It just gets worse. It's sad. It really is. But at a certain age, you gotta grow up. I mean, what the fuck? I don't know why anybody is obsessing about how I live my life and what I choose to do. Makes no sense. And they call me a cuck? The cucks are the ones obsessing about other men. What does a cuck do? A cuck sits in the corner and watches. Well, it's basically what some of you guys are, but you're sitting behind your phone or your computer watching. Right? But we call you cyber cucks. How's that? There's a new one for you. You cyber cucks. Keep worrying about what I do. How I spend my money, or I gotta pay child. So what if I pay child support? I'm not a fucking deadbeat. I have a great relationship with all my kids, a good relationship with their mothers. There's no drama. The only drama is this bullshit. That's why you just gotta shut off for a little bit and fucking ignore it. I've had I know this year's been tough for way too many people, and it sucks. But I've had one of the best years of my life physically, mentally, financially, relationship. It's been fucking great. The only bullshit is, you gotta hear this nonsense. But you know how it goes. I'm not triggered at all. Couldn't care less, dude. I live my life the way I want to, whether you like it or not. And no, I haven't been married 3-4 times. I'm married once. That's it. You're obsessed about doing... Well, you don't really show it, Lenny. Make yourself available. Let's do one tomorrow night. I'm not a Republican. I'm not a Democrat. I hate politics, dude. They're all full of shit. We'll see how this asshole does if he gets... If, you know, if Trump doesn't win his appeals or whatever. It doesn't matter. He's gonna... Whatever... Fucked up shit happens, Trump is gonna get blamed for it, so. I saw today, too, that fucking mayor of Los Angeles, I don't know if this is true. He said something like, if they find out you have more than allowed people in your house, they'll shut your water and electric off. What the fuck country are we living in? Jesus Christ. And another meme I saw which made complete sense, if the first lockdown worked, why another one? If it didn't work, why another one? The bullshit is right in front of us, and people still fall for it. I said it, when all this shit happened, you're gonna see how many imbeciles. The percentage of imbeciles in this world is probably more than 50%. People are fucking dumb. Yeah, there's a virus, of course, but it's not like if you get it, you're automatically dead. Like, Jesus Christ. If you're so worried about it, stay home. Put your mask on in your home, and mind your fucking business. You know, we got mask police. People yelling at you from across the street, put on a mask. Oh, fuck yourself. If you're wearing one, you shouldn't worry about it, right? If it works... Fuck you worried about if I have one on or not. I know, I don't like talking about politics. It's fucking ridiculous. We don't know shit that goes on behind the scenes. Those motherfuckers are so corrupt. For Dutch misfits, any life advice? Oh, you're coming to me for life advice now, huh? Why don't you go to the other guy? He seems to have the greatest life advice. Go to college for 4 or 5 years and don't use your degree that you got. There you go. Now, the best... Just... I don't know, work, man. Work. Don't get into debt. Keep your credit score up. Pay cash when you can. So I tell you, when you're doing any work on your house, cars, whatever, you get a plumber over, he tell you a certain price, you tell him what about cash, you save money, man. But that's another thing the government wants to do is get rid of cash so they can fucking monitor all your spending, which is total bullshit. How many rails did I do last night? 2 rails. Where am I hiding the Harley? Who told you I got a Harley? Virus keep mutating and suddenly it becomes a problem, which is happening right now. Is it getting mutated, or is that what you hear? It affects everybody different, that's the thing, man. Just like most other illnesses. Yeah, toilet paper. That's another thing these fucking idiots are running out again to buy. So stupid. Why toilet paper? That's what I don't understand. Does the virus give you the shits? If so, just fucking wash your butt in the shower. What the fuck? Run out of toilet paper. Am I getting a vaccine? I mean, I'm not getting a vaccine until I know what the side effects are and if it's safe. I got vaccinated when I was a kid from the, you know, whatever they had back then, measles, mumps. I did get chicken pox when I was a kid. They didn't have a vaccine for that then. That sucked. They say, you know. Toilet paper is gold. I don't know why. I still don't understand that. If you have to go outside and spray your butt with the hose, what the fuck? No, we won't be wearing masks at the podcast. Me and her went to the mall a couple weeks ago. I posted a picture of that restaurant we ate at. And you have to wear a mask while you're walking around. Man, that's not... That was very fucking annoying. I gotta wear a mask at work when I'm in the building around people, but... You know... It sucks. It's not really not that big of a deal, though, you know? It's kind of good that people are... social distancing too. I don't think that's a bad thing, because the last thing you want is when you're on a fucking, you're in the line at the store or whatever and you feel somebody's breath on your neck. Holy fuck. That irritates the fuck out of me. Nobody's fighting in my yard. If people are over and a fight breaks out, what am I gonna do? But there's no scheduled fight here. I only said that because that other dildo was running his fucking mouth. And I said, they can have it here as long as I get to fight him. But he disappeared after that. What does it tell you? Gyms are making people wear masks still? I thought you don't have to wear it once you get on the equipment. Right, washing hands, minding personal space. That's right, I'm okay with that. And even a mask I'm okay with some of these ugly motherfuckers. I don't want to see their face or smell their breath anyway. But people driving around in their car by themselves with a mask on, you're a fucking imbecile. Listen, if me and Valerie split up tomorrow, that guy is never welcome or coming to this house ever again. I'll just make that fucking very clear. It has nothing to do with her, it's me. Crossed the line way too many times, and there's no coming back for it. And like I said before, fuck forgiveness. I don't have to forgive anybody. Yeah, it's a secure, it tells it, yeah, the masks, all they do is give people some sense of security, but whatever. Prince Andrew's good. I spoke to him 2 days ago. I'll ask him why. Why did he? How's the Lord doing? Jason's doing good. Because people are wearing masks and social distancing, COVID is up because if all that shit works, how come it's still spreading? You can't have more, they want you not to have more than 5 people in your house, but if you want to go riot and loot and protest, by all means, thousands mashed together. That's fine. What the fuck? Where the fuck are we living? What the fuck is going on? That's what I want to know. It's like an alternate fucking reality this last year, I swear. I don't understand it. And this will probably be deleted by Zuckerfuck and his Instagram police, because I don't agree with their stupid fucking agenda. That's another reason why we don't do a lot of videos
or posts or podcasts, because you should get shadow banned now anyway. Demonetize and shadow ban right off the fucking bat. The two videos me and Lenny did, demonetize because of the music in the second one. And the first one in here, I don't know what the fuck we said or did to get it demonetized and shadow, but it's fucking bullshit, man. I heard there's a new platform called Rumble, which is like a YouTube. We have to look into that. And then there's another Parlor, I guess it's like an Instagram. We gotta look into that too. That's why, you know, I can't, yeah, Zuckerfuck. Shadow ban is when they don't put your video up for suggested videos. I think that's how it works. So you just, you know, because the video started getting less and less views. Just because you mentioned the virus is when he says the virus. Or if you know. That's what I was finished with. You know, the Democrats are all fucking pussies now. Well, they've always been pussies, but they're all about censorship. Fuck them. I will not support that shit. As much as certain things, yeah, you don't like to watch, don't watch it. Change the fucking channel. Who cares? Now, the doxing and all that shit, you know, that's ridiculous. Zucker cuck. He sharded. Oof. That sucks. You gotta be careful of those gamble farts, man. Especially after a night of drinking. If you feel a heater down there, you better go sit on the toilet. Masks reduce the amount of people that get infected. Great. That's good. That's what they tell you. They need to hide Trump ballots down here, man. This is a red state. Florida was a shoo-in for him. Florida, Texas, just like California, was a shoo-in for Biden. Didn't you just ask how Andrew is? He's good. I talked to him the other day. He's working a lot now. This is his season. Me and him both. Love from Scotland to go there one day. Weed cures the virus. Do a video with Lenny at Neon Vibe Fitness. What's that? How is it? The Nate Brooks gym? No thanks. I'm not going to any gym. I still have a membership to LA Fitness. I could go there once in a while, but I'd rather work out here. It's a lot easier. I can listen to whatever music I want. And it's 10 steps from my house. Do I fart in front of Taco Queen? No. It's disgusting. I don't want to hear her fart. I know she doesn't want to hear me fart. Definitely don't want to smell my farts. Yeah, it is sad. It's stupid. Whatever gives him satisfaction, you know, it's low. There's so many other people to talk shit about, like, I don't know, makes no sense. But that's what happens when you're a spoiled brat. I've worked for everything I got. I never got any fucking handouts. No matter what you say, oh, he's got to pay this much in child support. Oh. Well, guess what? I'm fine with it. I'm not bitching. I can afford everything I need. It's what it is, man. Why would you obsess about what another man does? I don't understand it. If I was crying to you about it, maybe I'd get it. But come on, man. I don't give a shit. Glenn Danzig is better than Pantera in your opinion. Everybody's got an opinion. Opinions are like assholes. Everybody's got one and they all stink. Oh, here's Pumps. There's another one that fell victim to the online fucking bullshit, getting harassed. It'll never end. This is how it's always been with us. Just gotta roll with it at this point. But Going after family members is fucked up. Especially when you agree like men not to. And then you break that agreement. It means you're not a fucking man, you're a chump. You know who I'm talking about too. The jellyfish, cyber cuck. I may not be college educated, but I do have pots to piss in and windows to throw them out of, so eat my balls. Dude, if I put a mask on doing this shit, I'd pass the fuck out. You're supposed to breathe in the carbon dioxide you breathe out. It's not gonna show up. It's not coming here, and I'm not going there. That's another, you know, some life advice. Don't ever go looking for a fight. It's the worst thing you can fucking do. It's stupid. If it happens, it happens. You know? Yeah, I have three children. And they're great. They're all happy and healthy. What do they do? Do your balls smell like vinegar? I don't know. I don't smell my own balls. I mean, I can't rub my fingers down there and give a little sniff. I remember fingering a girl in high school, and she had my buddy. I came up and I wiped my fingers right under his fucking nose. That was fucking hilarious. He was so pissed. He was smelling her pussy for a day. They call that a dirty Sanchez. I guess the work, right? I don't know, dude. It's fucking, my God. What do you guys type with your fucking toes? Does your taint smell like gasoline and ranch dressing? I fucking hate ranch dressing. Yeah, Jason still works at Publix and does that Instacart shit. Stop this. Time to train legs. Fuck. Alright. Turn this shit off. Oh, the dirty Sanchez involves shit. Okay. It's not just pussy juice across. Alright, you guys want to see the gym? Let me flip this fucking camera. Get the water coolers thanks to Danny Almeida. I put the treadmill over there because that thing is so fucking heavy, I can't move it. No, I did not flip the mat yet. Because I'm going to have to move this to flip the mat, and I can't. I put this fucking thing together in that corner, and it was, there's no way you could do flies if you'd hit this machine, so I had to move it over here, which isn't a bad spot. This thing is a piece of shit. It works, but it's shaky. So I don't go more than 225 on incline or decline because I shift too much. That's still up, not coming down. This ton of fucking weight. Got a bunch of other hookups too. Chuck E. Cheese Ranch, I think you sent that, this tricep thing. I don't remember who sent the rope. The guy sent the curl bar. I got everything I need, really. There's supposed to be more shit coming. I don't really need much else. Maybe a leg. If I do, I'm gonna have to extend it out to here. I put all these over here. I got plenty of room. Once Lenny gets his fucking bed out of here. You know what? Maybe I'll auction Lenny's bed off. Who wants it? How much would you guys pay for this? What's up, Dale? Let's start the bidding. Lenny, you don't need this fucking bed, do you? I know it's pretty new. Get some tranny juice on there. Have an inversion table that I'm missing a couple pieces. Or I'd flip it, but. Lenny, how much you want for your bed? What do you think the maniacs will pay for this piece of shit? We need to get it the fuck out of the way. I'm gonna put, once the more equipment comes, you're gonna have to put it out here. No AC, but who gives a shit? The weather's so nice right now. I don't know where the fucking dogs went. They're probably digging. See the yard. Yard's all right.
What a beautiful fucking day. It's like 78 degrees.
To do a fire later. All right, let me show you guys the fucking cut it into pieces and have them sign pieces of a bet. That's disgusting, Pumps. That's just what, how am I gonna cut the bed into fucking pieces anyway? You want to see what the butcher looks like? Where is he? Come here. Did you bathe them yet, or can I take them out? Come on, come on, get up. Come on. Why the fuck did that just do that? Oh, I hit the wrong button. Hey, bitch. So it's up to the idiots. Come here. We need to fertilize shit, dude. We're in South Florida. Everything grows. Where's she at?
Go on, go outside.
Where'd she go? There he is. Good boy. Hey. Damn, man, that's a long piss. See, I knew you had to do something. He's got some good muscles on him. Dogos are muscular dogs. His dad is a dogo. Mother is a pit. They told us that, the rescue told us that she was a King Corso American Bulldog, but I'm almost guaranteed she's a blue pit. It's hard to get rid of pit bulls down here because a lot of homeowners associations don't allow them. I need to teach him to lift his leg. He's a puppy still, man. He's only a couple months old. His paws are pretty big, though. I'll bring that paw. I'm going to show him. He's got all this loose skin to grow into. Go ahead. Josh Deb. What's up over the pond? Yeah, it's fucking great out here, man. It's nice and peaceful. People out here are cool, too. A little far from work, but that's all right. I'm gonna watch out for dog shit. Ever think about adopting a former racing greyhound from Palm Beach? Yeah, they have the... They're actually very good dogs. A house I bought years ago, the owners had two of those. And they were very, very cool. Big, but no, two is enough. We got two now. I'm not getting any more dogs. That's enough. Two dogs and that fucking lizard. That's good enough. All right. Anything else before I go? I'm over this. Jimmy Ludds, you sick bastard. That fucking guy sends me videos of him fucking lot lizards in his truck. That woman, that fucking lady, that Italian broad that you said, dude, she was like fucking, she looked like she was 65 years old. And he's fucking giving her a facial. That was so disgusting. Dude, don't send me that shit anymore. Releasing any tapes. Eight is enough. Eight dog, no. Yeah, I didn't want to have any dogs for a while because I was living in an apartment, and that's, you can't have dogs in an apartment. I mean, you can, but it's not. I got an acre and a quarter. How can you not have dogs out here? A tiger? You should get a tiger. Thanksgiving, everybody eats.
eat and grow. Older women do it the best. Okay, buddy, whatever you say. I don't use VO5. I use shampoo. They are banging a 47-year-old at the moment. Okay, hey man, whatever floats your boat. Who cares? It's whatever you like. Bully breed. I still have that shirt you sent me. Got two bully breeds. No, Jason's gonna have Thanksgiving with mommy, I think. Saul, I'd have to ask Andrew. I think he's still alive. He's pretty fucking decrepit now.
He's like 85,
if I'm not mistaken. But Andrew communicates with his daughter on Facebook. I think he's fine. Yeah, that's why I put motor oil in my hair. Yeah, exactly. I told you, this is lube for when I go to your mom's house on my mail route. She doesn't like spit. What about Big Richard? I talked about Richard earlier, so you can go back and watch this. Maybe I'll save this and post it. Needs more than a psychiatrist. PlayStation 5? No. I heard those fucking things are going for like $1,500. Or they started at $500, but they sold out, so the people that got them were fucking selling them for $1,500. That's insane. I don't care what that asshole wants. He's another fucking mush brain. Thanks, Dale. Yeah, we'll see you in a few months. But you know what? If that's what he wants his channel to be, it's never going to go anywhere. It'll never get monetized. I mean, even if it does, he's not going to make any money off it. He's just burning bridges for no fucking reason. All for no fucking reason. No reason. I don't get it. It's ridiculous. And that's a typical move by him too, saying, you know, because he got his buddy, or maybe it was even him with a fake account, I don't know, the pancake tits talking shit about Valerie being with black dudes, which she is totally false. But that's his move. He did it to his girlfriend, who's also a single mother, by the way. When she pissed him off a couple of years ago, he went on her Facebook and she told me, she messaged me all this shit. His mom and his girlfriend messaged me all the time about how sad it is, how fucked up he is. It's terrible. He went on her Facebook and wrote, "Linda fucks ends." She said that was a fucking nightmare. So that's his move. So that's why he, you know, and he's trying to do all kinds of shit to push Valerie away from me, which is not going to work because she knows this is all nonsense. So let's make some shit up to try to piss Brad off that Valerie's been with black guys. First of all, anybody that says, "Oh, I would never be with a chick that's been with a black guy," that says, number one, you're a fucking bigot. Number two, you're probably very insecure. What's the matter? You scared? You can't satisfy a girl that's been with a black man? Part of the shrimp gang? That's little dick energy. Okay? And any straight guy that tells you they wouldn't fuck J-Lo, any of the Kardashians, Tiger Woods' ex-wife, Kobe Bryant's widow, I mean, just, you're homosexual or you're part of the, you know, you got that little dick energy. So go fuck yourself. Fucking loser. He tells you, I mean, he exposes himself in every video. calls his own mother a whore. Can't respect your own mother. You don't respect anybody, not even yourself. He's a fucking filthy piece of shit. That's that, like when he says, human filth. And then going out, you know, talking shit about my daughter. Yeah, my daughter has cerebral palsy. She's handicapped. I don't advertise it because I'm not looking for anybody's sympathy. She's a very happy kid. You know, it's rough at times, but she's great. Bigot, yeah. You never heard the word bigot? Nate is someone, I'd say little dick energy. That's what it is. You see these guys that drive the fast, loud cars. That's little dick energy. Big lifted fucking trucks. What are you trying, what are you compensating for? Please. Yeah, it is low. Why would you, you know, say that shit? It's just trying to get at me, trying to get under my skin, so I talk about it like I am now, which I shouldn't have, but whatever. Just so we're all clear, so there's no misunderstandings here. I'm aware of all the bullshit I get sent, all the clips. It's fucking ridiculous. But again, somebody, he's crying out for attention. And another, you know, he's very pissed because like Lenny said, is it, easy psychological read. This is somebody that grew up privileged, family had money. It's a complete tragedy that he lost his father at 10 years old. I don't wish that on anybody, and that's horrible, okay? But mother never had to work. He got everything he ever wanted. Summer camps, trips, spoiled fucking rotten, okay? So you know he learned how to be a manipulator at a very young age. Oh, no, you can't have that toy. Miss my dad. Okay, baby, JJ, we'll get you whatever you want. No problem. Whole life. Now, when he needs money from mommy, he'll call, leave nasty messages. Ruin my life. You know, just lash out. He's a sick fucking person. He's a sick fucking person. He said his dad Duffy was murdered. He was a drug dealer or some fucking thing. Oh. Maybe he had a big fucking mouth too and was a rat. Maybe that's where he got his big mouth from. No, I'm not going to the Olympia. Maybe. I can't say no. Not for sure. So anyway, that's what happens when you're... If you guys choose to have children, do not spoil them. It's okay to spoil them if they appreciate it, if they're not little fucking turds, if they're not brats about it. Throw temper tantrums anytime they want something. You can't do that shit. Yeah, it does make sense. That's what it is, you know? Actually, that Train to Be a Freak has a YouTube channel. He did a couple videos about us. He was right about a lot of shit. Not all of it, but a lot of it. Like saying I've been married three times. No, I've been married once. One time. That was it. I had two kids with her and then... my youngest with another lady after. It's all right. Hey, listen. He's got to live in his misery, and I don't know why he's so concerned about how I live my life. And why anybody else would be either. I'm the one that has to walk in my shoes, nobody else. And I'm okay. I'm okay with it. I'm not complaining. First world problems. Exactly. Dude, fucking... his mom's wealthy. Gets whatever he wants. It's, you know, look. You'd say you don't blow your fucking inherit. You have 5 years in a Jeep. 5 years of college to be a truck driver. Congratulations. You're so fucking smart. You're so smart. But I'm the idiot, right? I'm the idiot. He said on a post the other day I responded to, I can't get out of my head that he's going to pay over $500,000 for his three kids. So what? They're my kids. That's my responsibility. I don't care. I'm not a fucking deadbeat. I love my kids. I always wanted to have kids since I was a kid, so I have no problem with that. I'd rather blow $500,000 on three kids than on fucking malt liquor and steroids. and a college degree that's useless. Congratulations. You got life all... He's the one that acts like he's got everything fucking figured out. Listen to me. Listen to me. Don't be a cock. Don't go with a single man. Even though my girlfriend's a single man. Fucking hypocrite. Hypocrite. You guys knew I had to come out. You know, I had to talk some shit about this. But this is good. This is good for him, because now he can go on another drunk rant and talk more shit about me and my family and Valerie and her kid. She does know who the father is. It's another stupid thing he said. Oh, they don't even know who the father of that kid is. Please, just making shit up. And some of you dopes believe everything he says. I'll tell you the fucking truth. I got no reason to lie. And yeah, I did spill some information about him that I got from his mom's boyfriend when I dropped off the tire change. The fucking guy, Joe, he actually called me the other night. He calls me. He's like, hey, I didn't tell you not to say anything. Fuck him. When I brought the tire change over, he's like, throw those fucking things away. Like, you should have thrown them away. I said, yeah, I'm not like that though, man, you know? Even all the shit, and I could have done that, but I didn't. Brought his mail over there, which, you know. Yeah, I told him, changes, I don't want to deal with his, he gets his personal mail to the P.O. box, which I pay for the P.O. box. It's not free just because I work there. Never offered me any money for the P.O. box. It's not a lot. It's a fucking $115 a year, big deal. But still, he's a fucking user. Go fuck yourself. Get your mail to your mommy's. He was crying because he said his mommy throws away his mail. She doesn't throw away his fucking mail. The boyfriend hid steroids that he got delivered there. And Jay, I never got the steroids, but he hid them because he didn't want him to take them while he was staying there because he acts like a fucking asshole. So he gave them to him the day he left. He just hid them. So. So whatever. And Debbie told me, I don't throw away his mail. I said, okay, well, you can get his mail now.
Did you see your dog?
What? What'd she do? Him? Oh, fuck. He's probably covered with fucking dirt.
Come here.
What, he roll around in shit or something? What the fuck, man? Look at this asshole. What'd you do? Oh, we got another digger. Did you show him that? Good luck. Wash his ass out here. Good God. Anything else you want to know about that fat fucking pig, the jellyfish? Jellyfish J. There should be another troll account. Jellyfish J. Cyber cuck. Cyber cuck of the year. Yeah. She said, don't say anything. Fuck him. I've kept my mouth shut long enough. Come on. I don't care if Chuck E. Cheese records this. Now I know Jay will watch it. He watches everything I do. He's a fucking cuck. Every little post from Muscle Sport Mag of any chick liked by Jay. And you want to call me a cuck? It's my dick, dude. Don't go to his channel for life. If I know you guys, you know what it is, and I told him this too. I said, you're just embarrassing yourself. They're laughing at you, not with you. They antagonize you to say and do stupid shit, and you fucking fall for it. It's such a gullible fuck. I was tricked. Brand called me a living abortion. I don't remember ever saying that. I think I've said it to Jason before. I don't remember ever saying it to Jay, and if I did, whatever. I was joking. Who gives a shit? His mom should have swallowed him. The load his mother should have swallowed. There's no peacemaking. There's no coming back from the shit that he said. You don't attack innocent kids. That's fucked up, man. That is fucked up. The only thing I ever said about his mom is that I'd like to fuck her, which I was joking. And that's a compliment because she's older and still looks good. He scared away any good potential stepdad that he could have had. Fucking guarantee you on that. Because he's jealous. He needed all the attention. He needed all mommy's attention. I mean, mama. Mommy. Training advice, maybe, but still, like, okay. When you aren't steroids, and any of you guys in here that are experts on, aren't they supposed to make you look and feel good? Not look and feel like shit? What the fuck? What's happening? Either he's getting fucking total bogus shit, which I know he's not, because I know where he gets it from, or just, you know, you can't just do steroids and it's I can do. You can lift fucking a lot of weight. Man, be a tough guy. But I got a beard and tattoos, so I'm real tough. Yeah. I love how he says that. Do you have a beard and tattoos? Now he's got a beard and he's got a little baby sharky on his leg. Baby sharky. Sing that song for him, baby shark. It's so easy. I hate, you know, it's ripping into him is so fucking easy. He's just such an easy target, you know. It almost doesn't count. It doesn't count. And you guys know, it's been a back and forth shit for years now. You've heard podcasts of me going off on him and saying how I still feel the same way. Fucking, you know. It's a saboteur. Sabotages everything. What happened to the great videos he was going to film while he was here? You know, he was here for a week. You didn't see nothing. He filmed one little clip of the when he had alcoholic shakes lifting 405, benching 405 for like four at his, at Linda's daughter's gym down there in Margate. You see the hands shaking. He didn't drink for a week because he was staying with Linda. She doesn't let him drink when he's with her because he's a belligerent piece of shit. What does that tell you? Now you're going to go on his next live and say, oh, Brad was talking all kinds of shit. Go ahead. Tell him to come watch this too. I don't have him blocked. If I was a real bitch, I'd block him. Lenny and Jay don't talk. Lenny thinks Jay's a fucking piece of shit. He's not going to say it publicly because he doesn't want the wrath of the trolls. You know, everybody knows he's a piece of shit. Just fucking ignore him. Lenny feels bad for him. He's sad for him. But Lenny has more of a heart than I do. I don't feel bad for the guy. When you're an adult and you're somewhat, he isn't stupid. He's gullible. But he's not a stupid person. He just does stupid shit. So I quit drinking for a year. And what did that do? He was still fat. But you know, like what are you trying? He's just slowly killing himself. And then he just blames it, you know, he blacks out. You know, like Linda said, you know, she's like, I didn't believe him when he said he blacks out and talks all that shit. But now she believes it, but she's with him because of Stockholm syndrome. She's scared of him because the one time she kicked him out, she didn't pick him up from South Dakota when he blew his fucking knees out like a dope. He got pissed at his mom and her because they were like, you know, figure it out. Linda didn't come. So he posted her fucking phone number. People still call her. When he did that, she called me. Can you tell him to stop? I said, what am I going to do? I can't tell him to stop. She had like 6 hours straight she was getting phone calls. She still gets phone calls. So it's like she stays with him out of fear. Because if she dumps his ass, then he's going to troll her. Go on her Facebook, have you guys dox her work. It's fucked up, man. He's a fucking sick person. And now he won't go to his mommy's. If Joe told me, because Joe called me the other night, he's like, I know you shared what we talked about, and that's okay, because I didn't tell you not to say anything. But it worked in my favor now. He won't come here if I'm here. Told his mom, I'm not coming over there if he's there. Like now she's got to dump her boyfriend for telling me a few facts. Give me a fucking break. Maybe the 500 a week was a little, because the guy's an alcoholic, you know, he's an alcoholic too. So whatever, he's not going to always tell the truth, but I'm sure he exaggerated some of the shit he told me. But whatever.
Yeah, I hope I cleared everything up now. Now you guys know where I stand. No, he's never welcome in my house again. No, do I never want to see that fat piece of shit again. I can't even stand his voice. A lot of the clips that you guys DM me, I don't even watch because I don't want to hear his fucking stupid mouth with that fucking underbite. He's almost got like a speech impediment. His head's getting so fat, his ears look small, he's got a fucking dent. His head's like fucking dented. It's like morphing before our eyes. That alcohol is really fucking him up, man. Malt liquor, boy. Eesh. It's terrible. Yeah, Joe's told me he slammed him on the ground a couple times. He got pissed off. And that's real charming. Classy guy. You see, money can't buy class. Am I gonna adult? Yeah, I'm gonna adult today. Prince Andrew's cool with everybody. It's not his beef, you know what I mean? And I don't listen, what happens between two other people that I'm friends with, I could still be friends with each person. If they have issues with each other, that's between them. You get involved. Andrew doesn't like being involved in shit. Jay messages him. A couple months ago, Jay wanted Andrew. He begged fucking Andrew. I can tell you this, because Andrew doesn't care. He fucking begged Andrew to do a video saying that Jay's kicked out of the Misfits. Come on, we need to stir up some controversy. He's just, it's so fucking dumb. It's so dumb. He tried that shit. We knew he was a fucking snake in Vegas. He was such a goddamn baby the whole time because he was pissed that Johnny Bravo didn't show up to Vegas. Because his plan was to just spend the whole time with Johnny Bravo and talk shit about us to create some kind of WWE kind of beef shit. You know, it's so fucking stupid. It's so stupid. It's so dumb. And he didn't get his way because Johnny Bravo didn't show up and he was pissed. Jay's a fucking asshole. He's a fucking asshole. What sucks, it's disappointing to me because he can be cool. He's funny. He has some great fucking one-liners when he's sober, even when he's sober or drunk, but then he gets fucking malicious and nasty and wants to fucking go after people. It's crazy. How many people is he challenged to a fucking fight? And you want to call me tough guy? Oh, Brad. Okay, tough guy, Brad. Who's the tough guy? You're the one challenging people to fight, and then you back down. Then you fucking weasel your way out of it. You make excuses. Fucking Ray in California is in a fucking wheelchair and said, come on, bring it. And then all he called him and apologized because he was tricked again by a troll account that he thought was Ray. He was tricked. This gullible fuck. You guys are good, man. And Andrew has warned him. Don't fall for that shit, Jay. Don't fall for it. You know, fact check before you go after somebody. How many people? Lou. You fuck with Lou. Why? I don't know. No idea why. Because Lou called him the bedroom bullshitter. Because when Lou got all those hookers to the Memorial Day thing, Jay didn't do a fucking thing. It was talk. Oh, I'm going to fuck this one. I'm going to fuck that one. I'm going to do it. All he did was clean up after Andrew Calora. Jay ate this girl's ass and pussy on the couch after Calora fucked her. Who's the cleanup boy? Who's the cuck? I bet you guys didn't know that one, did you? And then he went after Calora, after Lou. Then he talked shit about Calora. Maybe he probably didn't like the way his dick tasted. I don't know. And who was after that? Dale, Cornelius, guys that were nice. Hey, Dale picked him up from a truck stop, drove him to Cornelius' gym. They worked out, treated whatever, you know. Nice to him. Then he goes after his wife and kids. And I apologize to you, Dale, for ever telling you, don't take it too personally. He's just talking shit. No, fuck him. Fuck, you should have kept his ass blocked. And that's what pissed him off, that you blocked him. He went after Dale, Cornelius, backed out from them, PJ. How many people are living in... I mean, I'm glad his head's so fucking fat that we can all fit in there. Lenny, everybody. The only person he hasn't gone after is Andrew. Has he gone after Jason? Yeah, just about everybody. I mean, who the fuck does that? That's what you want to call a friend? Fuck him. Fuck him. He's a fucking clown. He's a fat loser, hypocrite, fucking pussy. 330-pound pussy. Fucking jellyfish. And then all of a sudden he wanted to suck PJ's dick when he came on the podcast. At the Olympia, he's like having a heart attack the whole time. because he had social anxiety. Those are some fun facts for you. And I don't even have to be drunk to be saying this shit. I'm drinking fucking Gatorade Zero.
Bridge an asshole. Malt liquor. Yes.
Every time he takes a sip, what the fuck? What the fuck? You guys look up to that piece of shit? Jesus Christ. Because he can do 505 for a double. Oh, who gives a fuck? Who cares? So you can lift a lot of weight. You're fucking 6 foot, 330 pounds. You better be able to lift a lot of weight. What the fuck? Eat a dick. Probably would eat a dick. It used to be okay. When he would get drunk, he'd call me and ask me to blow me and want to lick, you know, the last one's feet. Never got out of control. What else? Yeah, I did a video chat with Big Richard on election day. He's working the polls. And I go back in the beginning of this. I'll post it. Bench pressing isn't a good feat. Who cares? Who fucking gives a shit? I'm not a power lifter. He is. That's great. If you're impressed with yourself, you know, that's great. I don't give a shit. And take advice from him. Yeah, go squat 600 pounds and fucking blow your goddamn knees out when you're all loaded up with Winstrol. Real smart. Real smart. And then, you know, hey, listen, I may have bills, but I'm doing just fine, man. Yeah, I got 3 kids. So what? I'd much rather have my life than be 51 years old with not a pot to piss in or a window to fucking throw it out of. I mean, what the fuck are you talking about? Worry about your finances. Don't worry about mine. So what? If you have children, you have to pay for them. That's all there is to it. And if you don't, you're a fucking jerk off. You're a piece of shit. You would be a fucking deadbeat. Come on. That's what you're going to hold it. That's what you're going to make fun of me for? Give me a fucking break. The Jay McCuck thing, that's one thing I agree with Jay on. I will say this. The contract is fucking stupid. Him deleting his Instagram and YouTube, yeah, that's like you can see how important this shit is to him because he's got no fucking life. This is his life now. He even told Andrew it's like cocaine for him. He just can't stop. I get Adam's angle, but if you actually beat Jay's ass or even fight him, you want him to have a social media so they will fucking light him up. He'll have to block so many people. And that's another thing. You call me a pussy. How many people do you block, Jay? Because you don't like what they say. Because they agree with me. Oh, you're a brand fanboy. You must have a beard and tattoos. You're gone. What the fuck? But I do agree with there shouldn't be a contract. I'm telling you. All you got to do. You guys want to get a couple pairs of gloves, mouth guard, whatever. Whatever. You go to a public park. There's a fucking 100 of them in South Florida. Go to a spot where nobody's around in the field. You get 4 stakes. Tie a fucking rope around the stakes. However big you want the ring. Get somebody to ref it. So it doesn't get out of hand. A couple people there. Not many. Because you don't want to draw a crowd. You film it. You guys go at it for whatever your 3 1-minute rounds, which is another fucking stupid. I say no time. Just fucking go. Start. That's it. When you're done, you're done. That's it. How fucking... But you got to make it so difficult, it won't happen. Whatever. I'm not doing this. I'm not doing that. I'm not signing a contract. I don't blame not signing a contract. Fine. Simple liability, so... They don't go after each other. Don't try to sue each other. Jay likes to sue, too, just so you know. He got a nice chunk of change from a lawsuit, too, that he fucking blew right through. Why don't you ask him about that, too? He fell at work. That's why he's too much of a pussy to do a real truck driver's job and unload a truck. He slip and fall and got to sue. Yeah.
Right. It's not about the contract. He's a fucking spineless, gutless fucking coward. Like, the guy that you, all the people that Jay has called out to fight, Adam is the one with, as he would say, the worst genetics ever. Okay? The softest, you know, weakest, whatever you want to say about him. And he's even backing down from him. And if you're so positive that you can kick Adam's ass, why wouldn't you just sign? Yeah, fuck it. If you beat my ass, fuck it. I will delete all my shit. He would want to delete all his shit if Adam whooped his ass because of the fucking trolling he would get. He'd probably just delete it on his own, to be honest with you. There's no reason. So, yeah. It's never going to happen. It's all fucking talk. Jay's going to ignore it now and pretend, you know, he's good, but he'll just... Oh, I'm ignoring. I'm not going to talk about that anymore. Adam sent me a clip of one of his lies. I don't know if it was his last one or not. And Jay was so fucking... I'm not talking. That's it. I'm not talking about Adam anymore. What are you fucking scared of? Why do you... Stop making excuses. Like I said in one of the posts, put up or shut up. Quit saying you're going to fight people. You're going to do this. You're going to do that. Do it. Fucking do it. Quit talking. It's all to just get traffic to his channel. Meanwhile, he gets no fucking views. All he wants is to get monetized because he's jealous of Lenny. Because Lenny got monetized and he sees when Lenny does live streams, he gets the super chat money. So Jay wants a little bit of that. He wants a piece of the pie. Meanwhile, if his shit gets monetized, he ain't gonna make dick. He won't make dick. All right, is that enough for you guys? Do I need to say some more? I got a lot more, but I don't want to go too far. Hey, I offered Lenny. I said, I have an extra room, a front room that has a separate door to it. It doesn't have a bathroom in there, but we could work something out. He could live here. I told Lenny he could live here. I told him that a while ago. If he's ever in a bind, he's more than welcome to stay here. Valerie loves him. She know, Lenny is, you know, he may be all this big boisterous and a psycho online. Lenny is a good-hearted, respectable person. He really is. And no, she didn't ruin the fucking the gym video we had here. We had to get going because we had to be at the place and she had to do his makeup. But then she ran out of time because she had to do other people's makeup. So I did his makeup. I should have filmed me doing his makeup. It was pretty funny. Yeah, going on. Saying that shit about my daughter, man, that's it. Go fuck yourself. He's never even met my kid. He's only met my son. He didn't meet my other two daughters. He didn't even know I had a brother and a sister until I did Leo's fucking interview. That's how much Jay knows about me and my family. And he says something about, oh, Brad, saving Jim. My parents never split. They've been married since they were fucking 19 years old. They're 66. Do the math. They've never split. I had a good home life. My parents both worked. I worked for everything I got. I never got handouts. Okay? So you can make fun. You can talk all the shit you want. And it's okay if people get handouts. I'm not criticizing anybody that's born into money, doesn't really have to work for a living and get everything handed to them. But if they appreciate it and respect the people that are giving them the fucking money, that's one thing. But treat your own mother like a piece of shit when all she's done is everything she could for you? Go fuck yourself, dude. You're a clown. Hates blondes. Mother's blonde. Why do you hate blondes? Because you hate your mother? How could you hate your mother? Well, because she just gave you shit and didn't pay attention to you? Maybe. That could be it. Who the fuck would want to be around you anyway? No, Valerie never got EBT handout. That's another stupid... He likes to make shit up. And when I spoke to him on the phone about that, I'm like, I don't know. He's like, it's not true. Why do you care? I'm like, Jay, you can't make false accusations like that and not expect people to get aggravated. Like, well, if it's not true, who cares? I'm like, well, why are you making shit up about us? What is your problem? Just because I told you you're not welcome here anymore? Well, you're not. And it's not because of her. It's my fucking decision. Okay? I don't want that motherfucker around me anymore. He annoyed the fuck out of me when he was here anyway. He's a disrespectful cocksucker. I don't need people like that. I got plenty of friends, dude. I don't need somebody like that in my life. He's a scumbag. Any other good stories? I got a lot. I don't know. I got a fucking shitload of texts from Linda and Mommy, though. You want to keep running your fucking mouth? Those can be spread out there, too, asshole. You could say, you know, he gets all... One of the texts he sent, you said mean things about me. What are you, 12? What the fuck? You said mean things about... How much shit have you talked about me, asshole? So what if I leaked a couple things about you? Get over yourself, you fucking fat faggot. I shouldn't have said faggot. Nah, this will get deleted. Oh, well. If it gets deleted, Chuck E. Cheese Ranch on YouTube, go ahead. You can have it. I don't give a fuck. Just send me some more gym equipment with your monetization money, fucker. What was I saying? Now I lost my train of thought. God damn it. Hey, it's... I don't know. It's all stupid. It's okay for him to talk shit about anybody he wants, but the minute you talk shit about him, oh no. And JJ can't take that. Baby JJ can't take that. Mm-mm, I'm gonna call my mom. Mom, they're talking about me. And he wants to criticize Lenny. Dude, go. Please. What happened? He didn't play football because coach was too mean to me. That coach was too mean to me. What does that tell you? Read between the fucking lines, you guys. Giant privileged pussy. That's it. You know? He's an entitled little shit. Mommy. I told his mom, cut him off. I said, Jason's grandmother did it to him. Cut his ass off. He wants to act like an asshole and treat you like shit. Cut him the fuck off. Well, he's damaged. Hey, he's damaged. Yeah, well, guess what? You're a man. You can change. People can change. As you get older, grow the fuck up. This is what happens, though. Some people... I don't remember where I read it, but they say, it's a theory, I don't know if it's actually proven, but you stop mentally maturing at the age you start drinking. So that happens to some people. So that would explain a lot with him too, because he does act like a 14-year-old. Well, I think he started drinking when he was 14 or 15. So what does that tell you? Anyway, all right, I'm done ranting because I'm going to just keep going. It's going to get worse and worse. All right, guys, I think it's been over an hour anyway. Happy Thanksgiving. I got to train legs and eat some turkey. I'll save this. We'll see if Sucker Fuck wants to delete it because I said the word that rhymes with maggot. They took that out of the Dire Straits song, too. I heard it on the radio the other day. Give me a fucking break. People are too sensitive. Anyway, that's it.